Just saying.
Yeah.
Back here with Christopher Mannix talking Golden State Warriors. Are you a Christopher?
I am.
Oh, phew. That was close. Perhaps we'll never know the real reason Kevin Durant decided to leave Golden State, but his feud with Draymond Green was rumored to be partially to blame. And while both publicly said they patched things up from their November sideline verbal altercation, it may not be the case. According to Kendrick Perkins, KD never bounced back from the Draymond situation. So, Mannix, who is to blame for Durant's departure?
I don't think that blame is the word I would use in this situation.
Whenever, I tried to tell them this morning, that's a little strong.
Whenever a free agent leaves, like, whatever the sport is, stuff like this always comes out. Like, here's why they left. Hated coach X, didn't like teammate Y. It's just a long-standing tradition of the aftermath of free agency. My long-standing belief about the Durant situation was he was always a mercenary. And Golden State was never going to be his last stop. Even if they had won a third consecutive championship, I don't believe that Kevin Durant would have been back to try to win 4, 5, or 6 in a row. I believe he went to Golden State for a reason. And as the wandering eye that he was looking in other directions. He was looking for other things in his career as well. I mean, this is a guy that has expanded his business empire significantly over the last couple of years, has looked beyond just basketball. And being in New York, whether it was the Knicks or now ultimately the Nets, gives him those opportunities that are different for him.
So you said he went to Golden State for a reason. What was the reason?
Win a championship.
Yeah.
That was it. Simple.
And winning that championship, the respect that he would be able to get and hopefully be able to get closer to LeBron James. I think you did a great point, great job of pointing out that, man, athletes, greatest athletes, man, we have people that we target, we model, not only those who have played, but they could be currently playing. I know myself, Michael Irvin, Jerry Rice. Michael Irvin and Jerry Rice always talked about, we love you playing on the East Coast because we watch those games early. They come into the locker room after I play and be like, hey, man, I need to get 5 for 100 because Chris had 2 touchdowns or something like that. Those types of things are real. I think you made a great point as far as informing people in sports. Just no matter what it is, when a guy leaves, these little things, who's to blame? When typically, sometime, it was just the natural part of their career. And I believe Kevin Durant coming there, the credibility, and I thought he enjoyed the idea or concept of playing with Steph and Klay and the way they played basketball. But then once you get there, it becomes something different.
Anyone, listen, the last, if you break up after a fight, you did not break up because of the fight. You broke up because of everything that led to the fight, and the fight was the last straw. The fact that I will not abide, and I'm not, listen, there's certain things about Draymond I really like, certain things about Draymond annoy the hell out of me, but I'm not going to abide this being laid at Draymond's feet. That, oh, if Draymond just had kept his cool, had not called him a B-word, if he had just passed the ball to Durant on that fast break in that game against the Clippers, that Durant would still be there. That is nonsense. I'm telling you right now, around two years into us doing this show, around 3.5 years into Chris and I knowing each other, if Chris and I, after today's show, had a knockdown dragout, it would not end the partnership. Because the partnership is not holding on for dear life. There is enough, you'd have to get over it, we'd have to whatever it was. But this is, Kevin Durant went to Golden State. He thought, this is where I disagree, he thought he was looking for a championship. Because he thought getting the championship would, A, make him feel some type of way, fulfilled.
Fulfilled.
And B, would also, he already believed, I'm better than LeBron. These jokers in the media won't say it. Let me go win a title, hopefully against LeBron. Mm-hmm. And then he did it exactly the way he wanted to, winning MVP, hitting the shot. And then these jokers in the media were still like, well, LeBron's the best player. We all know LeBron's the best player. And so he was over. And then Marcus Thompson writes, and the other thing that he really wanted was a close, deep, almost familial friendship with someone on the team, and that didn't come either. So you had Kevin Durant, after that first title, feeling almost, according to the people that know him, worse than before, because he actually finally grasped the thing he wanted, mm-hmm, and realized, Well, if that don't make me feel whole, then what the hell can? Which is why during year two, we now know they were worried he was going to be out the door. And why when he came back after year two, after another title, when if Howard Beck knows he and Kyrie were talking about teaming up, of course the Warriors knew that Draymond 2 weeks into the season would be like, man, just leave. If you're going to be all in your feelings about not getting the ball, just leave already. And so it was Kevin Durant was searching for something he did not ultimately find. And I do not begrudge him that. But the idea that we're going to blame someone for Kevin Durant making the choice that he thinks will make him happy or fulfilled or fill up whatever is empty,
right.
That's unfair to Draymond and other people.
Mannix, what do you think he's searching for now? What is he looking for when he goes to Brooklyn? Well, is it the same thing?
He's going to get two things right off the bat. When he steps back onto the floor, it's going to be his team. Like, the Brooklyn Nets are going to be his team. And I think Kyrie Irving is fine with that because Kyrie Irving kind of realized the last couple of years the value of having somebody else be the alpha on that team. He's going to get to play with a close friend that he has a close relationship with already. So those two things immediately become things that maybe he didn't have with the Golden State Warriors. But it's interesting to talk about the familial relationships they didn't have. He had all that in Oklahoma City. Like, he had, maybe not with Russell Westbrook necessarily at the end, but, like, Nick Collison was, like, his best friend there. And they had a bunch of guys that worshipped at the altar of Kevin Durant. That whole organization builds itself as a family thing. I'm with you. A guy, Kevin Durant breaking up with the Warriors, there doesn't have to be a flashpoint. It doesn't have to be, you know, the fault of one guy or two guys or one relationship. Maybe Kevin Durant just knew, like, I kind of felt like I knew that he wasn't going to be a Golden State Warrior for the rest of his career. This was always a mercenary situation. Had a purpose. It served his purpose. And now he's on to the next thing.
I think at the beginning, he felt unfulfilled because he didn't feel like there's something he could do to rival how they felt about Steph. And just how in OKC, no matter what he did, they wouldn't feel about him the way they felt about Russ.
You think that's true, though? Like,
the Russ part?
That they wouldn't feel that, like, they would always be more more of allegiance to Russ than KD if they both were there?
Well, I just heard behind the scenes, KD had that feeling about Russ, and him and Russ weren't as close as people make it out.
That's true. To add to that, in that last year when Billy Donovan took over Scott Brooks when he was there, the dynamic changed a little bit. You know, Scott, I think one of Scott Brooks' greatest strengths was that he was able to kind of keep everybody in line and keep things on an equal playing field. I think it did tilt towards Russ in that last year in Oklahoma City.
Right. Now, I don't know this. I can just talk from people who've experienced. The great Walter Payton, after all those years of struggling with the Chicago Bears, they finally win the Super Bowl, beat the New England Patriots. William the Refrigerator scores a touchdown. Walter doesn't score a touchdown, but they ask him after the game, after all these years of training, all this, what does it feel like to be a champion? And he said, I have to tell you the truth. I thought it was more to it than that. And there's a lot of guys that win championships and they believe that that's going to be the awe moment for them. And then you realize you wake up the next day and you still have human issues. And to me, with Kevin Durant, it was about respect, and people were never going to respect him on the same level that they respected Steph Curry. And I'm cool with that. If he wants his own team, I'm fine with that. But I just believe him and Kyrie are more kindred spirits and on the same level than the relationship he had in OKC and the one he had with Steph.
All right, Mannix, stick around. Coming up, is Kawhi about to shape the entire NBA with his decision? Next on First Things First.
Let's check in with Chris Carter on that one.